When you pray, you will hear, why does God allow this problem or situation to you? So let not that situation make you to cry and make you to be sad. That's what the enemy does. When you pray, you shout to God, Lord, I have got plenty of water with me, and that flows through my eyes. No. God says, you have got, the moment you come and realize your problem, you understand the power in you, the light in you, the mission of God in you. God is sending you. He has trusted not ABCD, but you. You are the one He has found to take care of your husband, your wife, your children. Hallelujah.
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 Sixth one, as Manoah and husband, his wife prayed, the Lord revealed to them, as long as we are in the mission of God, Lord's protection will be with us. The moment we move away from the mission of God, the enemy will come to capture us. So as long as you move with the mission of God, as long as Samson was doing God's will, God was with him. But leaving God's plan, going around playing, okay, when he played with his wife, God's mercy came to him, though the wife went away. Again, he went and fell in the hands of a prostitute. God's grace came and protected him. God's mercy is different. Divine mercy is different. Divine grace is different. Divine mercy is given to you when you come to God and cry to him to forgive your sin, to show mercy to you. Divine grace is given to you though you don't deserve it. God provides you something of his. He is at the hand of a prostitute, lying at the lap of the prostitute. He is in the worst sin, but still God's grace comes and protects him. The Holy Spirit came upon him. He got up from the sleep, from the lap of the woman, took a donkey's bone and destroyed thousands of people. It's not because of the divine mercy. It is because of divine grace. Don't play with the grace. So many people are saying, grace, grace, don't run after. Grace is only for given to you. It is not if you have one house, you will get two houses. Grace of God. These are wrong interpretation. For the sake of to take away all your money from you, for them. The grace of God is a completely different truth. Do not be afraid, Paul. In your weakness, my strength will sustain you. Not to remove. Now current has gone. So the battery or generator sustains. All the light will not be burning. Only at least minimum to sustain you. That what you have done is wrong. You are making your mess of your life. You have fallen into the hand of a prostitute. Still God has protected you. Get up. Come to your sense. Return to God. If you don't return, the grace of God is not permanent. So next, the disaster, the fear, the power of God, the anger of God comes upon us. When God deals with man, the first stage is divine mercy. The second stage is divine grace. And the third stage only, the divine terror. If God's presence, the moment as we read in Judges chapter 16, we read that when the Spirit of God left Samson, he became helpless. And the enemy came and they plucked away his eyes. They tied him. What happened to his power? Did God leave him? God led him through the truth. What is the truth of God for man? Divine mercy. When you cry for your sin, he shows mercy to you. Even when you don't cry for mercy, still God helps you through his grace. You take divine mercy for granted, divine grace for granted, still you go on. That's why that sentence is a very beautiful sentence. It is written, like earlier times, now also I can shake up and go. He thought, but he did not know. Read, please.
So the Philistine seized him and gouged out his eyes. They brought him down.
Previous sentence, Thali. You should listen to what Father is saying. The previous sentence. In the book of Judges, chapter 16, I think verse 8. He did not know that the Lord has left him. Like earlier times. Did anybody find? Nobody found.
She let him fall asleep on a lap, and she called a man and had him shave off the 7 locks of his head. He began to weaken, and his strength left him.
Continue. Next
then
only
she
point.
Said, the Philistines are upon you, Samson.
Next sentence.
But he did not know that the Lord had left him.
Read the full sentence.
I will go out as at other times and shake.
He thought like other time, now also, God I can take for granted. God is only pachadi, pickle. If I have to eat this much rice, this much pachadi is enough. God is my pachadi, I can use him and come out of problem. He thought like earlier times, now also, I can go on sin until Lord have mercy and he will... Like earlier times, now also I can shake off and come out, he thought, but he did not know. Read.
And shake myself free.
Read the correct Thali, but he did not know that the Lord has left him. The Lord has left him. He did not know. Close your eyes. The word of God teaches us today. If you want the anointing of the Holy Spirit, it is not the desire that is going to make you draw you to the Lord. Number one, if life has to come out of you, you have to keep yourself clean and acceptable to God. Your external devotion, if it is not accompanied with the internal cleansing, the presence of God will not walk with you. Number two, consultation and togetherness is the base for the Holy Spirit to abide in you. Number three, take care of the flowing of the Holy Spirit in your life. That by doing 4 things, the Holy Spirit moves from Christ to you. Number one, you should be aware that you are part of heaven. Number two, you should hear the voice of God. Number three, you should know that you have a mission. God has sent you with a mission. Number four, God has placed you in problem because he has kept the solution in you. God has led you into darkness because the light is in you. Fifth, the Lord says, move from inside to out, not from outside to in. The Lord also tells us that you are sent into the world with a mission. The Lord says, as long as you are in the mission of God, God's protection will be around you. Forgetting the mission of God, playing with the mission of God, will make you to see that the protection of God moves from you. Don't take God and his anointing for granted, but be empowered by his love for you. Be amazed at the mission he has for you. His love never changes. His grace never changes. His anointing never changes. Make your life a worship. wherever you go, continue to praise him.